Hi, my name is Dan. In this video, we're going to be using Illustrator to build UI and web graphics. Okay, there's lots of free stuff here on my channel. Please subscribe, hit the little bell next to the subscribe button to get notifications. If you want more, loads more. Okay, check out bringyourownlaptop.com or check out the link in the description. There. In this video, we're going to bring in our lovely, sexy vector logo, and we'll drop in our nav bar, play with the opacity, and add a bit of type for our navigation. All right, let's go and do it. Right, so you can start obviously by replacing things. I often just go through, and this is what I've kind of used to, you know, get my ideas across to the client, but it's not something I find useful to start with. I kind of thought a bit more about the product, and I'll keep my wireframes close. I'll print them off and stick them close, but I don't kind of like switch them out verbatim. It's not that kind of design process. And so what I do is I'm gonna use them as a guide. Don't get me wrong, but I'm just gonna kind of let the content, you know, push and move and jiggle as it needs to. Okay, because I've got images from the client now, and I've got logos from them, and everything's changed just a slight bit. So I'm gonna bring in my logo. This is going to be my first bit, and it's going to probably drive a lot of the design, especially colors, maybe fonts. So we're going to bring it in first. Now, when you're finding logos from your client, make sure it's a vector version. And what we're going to do is we're going to go to File, and we're going to go to Place. Okay, this one here. And let's say the client, in our exercise files, I've got lots of logos. Okay, there are, five versions. So JPEG and a PNG are bad. SVG, EPS, or an AI file are good. The reasons are, I'll show you the kind of difference between the two. Let's say all of these three are very similar, pretty much the same. Okay, and these guys have a very similar sort of working as well. So let's bring in the PNG and let's bring in the, say, the EPS version, or let's say the SVG. Okay, let's see the difference between the two. And it's something called pixels versus vector, or bitmap versus paths. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn my guides off and I'm going to zoom in. Okay, so they look exactly the same, but watch what happens when I start scaling both of these two. So if I grab these guys and I start scaling them up, okay, nice and big, you can see one starts pixelating, looks horrible, and this other one here stays nice and crystal clear. So if you do have the option, the client says, which version do you want? Make sure you get the vector version, okay? And the vector is SVG, EPS, or AI. Sometimes it can be a PDF. Okay, but stay away from PNGs. PNGs are handy because they have transparency. So if you only have, say, a JPEG and a PNG, get the PNG version. Okay, it's not going to scale very well. That's not going to help us with our responsiveness. It's not the end of the world. Okay, but let's compare it with the JPEG version. JPEG is a clear loser because he has a white background. He's still the same kind of pixels. He still pixelates, but you can see at least the PNG has a transparent background often, not always. Okay, so goodbye, you guys. I'm gonna bring in our SVG again, just because it came through at the right size. SVG, great. Okay, and there's gonna be my logo for my site. Remember, be working at command one, actual pixels. Okay, and you'll notice that our logo has a white background. It's because what I wanna do is turn my guides back on. Okay, if you've forgotten, that's command colon or control colon. I'm gonna get it to kind of bang up, maybe just a little bit further in, because what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab my rectangle tool and I'm gonna put like a nav bar along the top. I'm gonna make it semi-transparent later on so you can kind of see underneath it and make it all cool. So I'm gonna move it across so I can see both sides. There we go. And I'm gonna draw a rectangle in here. It's gonna go across 12 columns. I'm gonna give it a fill color of black and I'm gonna give it no stroke. So the little red line through it means no stroke. I'll lower the opacity a little bit. Kind of goes a little bit gray, and I'm gonna put stuff behind it. Actually, when we build our site, we're gonna pin it to the top. So it means that it's gonna scroll down when we start scrolling, and it's gonna stick to the top, and we'll always be able to see the logo in the navigation. It's kind of cool. Anyway, now at the moment, the logo's on the wrong side. This box is on top, so we just right click it. Okay, if you're on a Mac, you hold down Control and click with any buttons you've got. Okay, on a PC, it's a little easier. You can right click and go to the one that says Arrange and go to Center Back. You can see I got my logo up front. Cool. I'm gonna tap it so it sits in there, turn my guides off, and it looks okay. Now what I wanna do is I wanna put in the text for my navigation. So I'm gonna grab the type tool and I'm gonna click once. Doesn't really matter where it goes. And I'm going to go about us. So about, it's going to be about me because it's my portfolio. And what I'll do is I'm going to copy and paste it, stick it up next to him. And there's going to be another page called Contact Me. Contact Me. Okay. I maybe have my portfolio button as well. I've decided just to keep my those images we had on the bottom to get to our portfolio. Okay, these are just kind of like these guys here. I'm going to make them white. So with the black arrow, I've got them both selected. Okay, I can grab my type tool now. And up the top here, I can go and change the color to white. Okay, actually, what I'm going to use is this off-white all the way through it. Okay, I don't know why I like it. It's just a little hint on the white. It looks white, basically. And yeah, so we've added our type. We're going to go and style fonts in a movie just after this one. We'll just use Arial for the moment. The next thing I want to do is I want to work with a little bit of color. So let's go and do that in the next video. How good was that, right? If you want more, go check out bringyourownlaptop.com or check out the link in the description.